Now we're gonna work on the arms, the wrist, the fingers. Hold the stomach in, give me a tall neck. Hands out, let's start with arms, circles forward. Come on. Low it out. And eight more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And reverse. One, two, three. Come on. Four, five, six, seven, eight more. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Give me some fists, please. Front. One, two. Keep straight. Three, four. Head up. Five. Stomach in. Six, seven, eight more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And reverse. Come on, you can do it. You can do it.
Come on, you can do it. Keep them on. Five, six, Can start making their nest.
I think you guys are gonna have fun. Harriet
Sorry
Penske
about the shakiness
in Sun City,
in the
Arizona.
Of this,
Harriet just got her first day-by-day motivational
won't have this problem anymore. But for
and
now,
she was thrilled
let's go.
With it. Harriet is just starting out again, and I'm sure she would love to hear from us. So what do you say? Let's give her a call. Sun City, Arizona.
What do we gotta do?
Harriet?
Yes?
Is this sweet and adorable, Harriet?
Well, I guess it is.
This is Richard Simmons calling. How are you doing?
I'm just fine. How are you?
Well, I'm doing wonderful. I got your letter, and I have to tell you, it was one of the most wonderful letters I've ever received.
Well, thank you. You turned my life around.
Why do you say that, Harriet?
unconscious through the madness and chaos. So I call on my angels. They say, oh, you have so little faith.
California, and meet your inspiration for this week, Donna Bunn. I usually would tell you Donna's highest weight, but even to this day, she doesn't tell anybody what it was. Let's just say it was well over 200 pounds. Donna is embarrassed and still shocked that she ever allowed herself to get so heavy. For most of her life, she didn't have a real weight problem, although she could have stood to lose a few pounds. At 21 years old, she met Steve, the man she would eventually marry. The two of them did some serious dating, and as Donna became more comfortable with Steve, she became less worried about gaining a couple of pounds here and there. When Donna's family packed up and moved to Oregon, Donna made the tough decision to move north with them. But she soon found she missed Steve very much. The weight was creeping on, but Donna didn't seem to care at all. Steve eventually traveled to Oregon to visit her, and Donna realized how much she needed him. So later she moved back to sunny California, where she and Steve would soon meet. On her wedding day, Donna was always there.
I'ma die, respect you. Follow my money, you get down like that. myself, not underground, underground. Haven't been myself, but it's okay, it's cool. Won't push the issue. What happens next? Story to be continued, yeah.
I've been living fast, 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 fast. Feeling really bad, 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 bad. Time really moves fast, 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 fast. But hurry up and get in your bag, 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 bag. I'm worthy, you are not a fan. I know these niggas getting mad, 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 mad. My hand on my trigger, I'ma die, respect, yeah. Fuck with my money, you get dog like that, yeah.
This is fire, yeah. This is fire.
Donna found herself alone all day while her husband was at work. No friends, no family, bored with her daily life. It was a recipe for disaster. Donna's days were spent with her friends from the fridge, and she quickly topped 200 pounds with no end in sight, or so it seemed. Remember that single event I mentioned that sometimes shocks us into reality? Well, Donna was in for a shock. She and her brother had gone whale watching off the beach resort of Dana Point near Los Angeles. After a fun afternoon at sea, they had to walk back to the bus that would take them home. Running a little late, Donna and her brother had to rush to keep from missing the bus. Her brother was walking, almost running at a brisk speed, trying not to let the bus get away, and at the same time, not leaving his sister too far behind. Meanwhile, Donna was huffing and puffing, quickly losing her breath, trying desperately to keep up. Self-conscious about her size, worried about what she must look like trying to run, she realized that that should not have been such a big problem for a woman barely 30 years old. She made it to the bus on time, but the experience made her think seriously about her condition. Donna thought back to all the times she had seen me on television, and she decided the time had finally come for her to tackle that weight problem. She was ready to get a deal immediately. No way was she going to face that kind of humiliation again. Right. Donna got her deal of meal cards, then a scale, and made a special trip to the grocery store to stock up on all the good foods she would need for healthier eating. Now, she admits that she'd eaten many of the right foods before, but the problem was she didn't know when to say enough. But now that she was planning her meals ahead of time, Donna was able to manage just how much she would eat at mealtime. And that's not all. Her bus chasing experience also convinced her of the importance of daily exercise. She started using my sweat and tapes, and although it was tough early on, she did as much as she could until the whole 60-minute workout was more like fun than a physical challenge. Today, Donna has lost 87 pounds and has just a few more to go, and she will reach her goal. Steve always loved Donna, no matter how much she weighed. But today he brags about the fact that he has his dear back. That's what he used to call her when they were still dating. Now, Donna's father was a different story, though. He had always given her a hard time about gaining weight. But he's a convert now. He's very supportive and even sends her a card now and then to encourage her. Donna is very excited. The family hasn't seen her since she lost all the weight. And in just a few months, she's going back to Oregon.
Oh my God, Bonnie.
White Jays, white horse, white wrist, white horse. Hi, bitch. Hi, bitch. Hi, bitch. Hi, bitch. I do not sniff it to run it.
Nope.
It do not drip when I pull it.
Nope.
I do not run, I reload it.
Nope.
I do not save it, I throw it. White Jays, white horse, white wrist. White horse, hi bitch, hi bitch, hi bitch, hi bitch. Please stop, please stop, please stop, please stop.
Stop it.
That fit look like you bought it at the Kia. And they got a nerve that ass like shit. Why you counting all that money that we got? I ain't worried. feet. Queen of Rack City, give me the key. I be like, send me the Addy. Hop out the Porsche with a baddie. Got a nice face and a fatty. Do what I say like I'm daddy. Been out here killing them. Yeah, the check costs about a million. Older made me about a billion. Yeah, we see who I should really own. Look, I don't got no curb, I got mileage. I'm always on the jet like a pilot.
Why are you following me? Afraid I was gonna leave without giving you a goodbye kiss?
I just assumed it was a Wookiee.
I can arrange that.
And use a good kiss!
Up there in you. is my desire. Break down the walls to connect, inspire. Up in a high place, liars. Time is ticking for the empire. The truth they feed is feeble, as so many times before. The greed of all the people. They stumble and they fumble and we about to riot. They woke up, the lions.
Hard to respect someone just because they outrank me, sir.
Puts you in a difficult position, doesn't it?
Yes, sir.
You don't like taking orders from Bonzo?
No, sir.
Perhaps you'd prefer to give them yourself.
Sir.
How'd you like to lead your own army? Dragon Army.
Sir, I've never heard of a Dragon Army.
We discontinued the name 4 years ago. No Dragon Army ever won a battle.
Then why not a new name, sir?
Because we already have the uniforms.
And who will be in this army, sir?
Misfits, like you. Oddballs, who might just be brilliant with the right commander.
No new quarters.
ストップ。砲の取れません。山を返し、サスの上空を行きます。勝負。仕方あるまい。あれは我らが一族のためなるものに違いない。必ず総司ホルケン様のもとへ届けねばならん。
I'm Bets Putnam Hidalgo. I'm representing Middle East Justice Now. And perhaps you're wondering what Middle East Justice Now has to do with the horrendous and tragic shooting that took place on Saturday. Well, when we focus on Israel-Palestine, we focus on a seemingly intractable...
貴様があの噂の竜とはな。
敵は全て殺す。
Hello, my name is Diana Hidalgo, and today I'm going to be giving my speech on the human development of Kings County. When you hear about Kings County, located in the San Joaquin Valley, one usually thinks about its rich agricultural region. With 87% of its acres being farmland, it brings in $2.3 billion a year. It's a wonderful thing to brag about. One thing that usually nobody talks about is
鎧、長き眠りから目覚めよ。貴様の名はエスカフローネ。俺の鎧だ。
Look at Mike Hyman hogging the vlog, Donnie!
Mike Hyman's just trying to get the... Oh, I see him. Thanks for the heads up.
I didn't see him. Sorry.
All of the United States...
He dug him out a little honey hole right here. So, oh, he's probably going to get the ladder.
Don't get the ladder.
We need to confiscate those water plants, Crusher.
After three simple ideas of the development, which are...
This is where Mike loses it right here.
This is taking too long.
And improving their overall well-being.
Alright.
You should have just let me reach in there and grab them.
It is vital. But it is only valuable if it enables more children to succeed in school, to live in safer neighborhoods.
Uh-oh, he don't like that, Mike.
Stop! Stop! Oh! Stop it!
I'm
trying to clean up your house anyway.
Where is he? Where'd he go?
He's on the ladder.
He's on the ladder?
Don't be crying while you're slicing on it. It's time to mix into garlic cloves. When they were
always have me cooking on the stove. The recipe needs crushed tomato. 20 ounces of sweet, but you let it flow. Be patient, I'ma teach you how to make it.
Please turn up the bass, got that steam in my face. I'm mixing 12 ounces of that tomato paste. Got 2 6.5 ounces tomato sauce placed in the pot. Mix with grace, half got water, don't waste. On the mix, and the sugar, dig it up like a booger. 2 tablespoons if you wanna be a good cooker. Nothing more, nothing less. Gotta pay but a book. 1.5 teaspoon, drop it, at least scoop up.
Drop it and be gentle. Half a teaspoon of fennel. Tell you season in, you sprinkle from a teaspoon utensil. Tablespoon of sauce essential to the taste. It's not just mental. Don't put too much accidental. No take backs, this ain't a rental.
1/4 teaspoon of that black pepper. Whip it and mix it to make it better. 2 tablespoons of mix together. Whip up the sauce like tornado weather. Cover the top, let it simmer for now. Just let it cook for 1.5 hours. Stirring occasionally, mixing it out. Taste be so good that you wanna devour. Wow.
I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make it. I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma
teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make it.
I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. Take a pot and then you pour some water. Take some salt and then you pour some on it. 12 noodles light around the corner. And no, I can't forget to mention, 8 minutes till it's al dente.
Actually, it's like 6 minutes. Then let the sauce soak up in it.
Pour some water, cool it off. Make sure those noodles ain't sticky. We need a ladle for sauce. Rinse it until it's undripping. 16 ounces of Ricard. Cracking it, ain't mighty drinking. 2 tablespoons, 4 tablespoons is what's missing. Flick up the rice, now you have to start mixing.
Whip.
Sprinkle some sugar inside.
Whip.
Preheat to 375.
Put a sauce in the bottom of the dish.
1.5 cups will suffice.
Take them noodles like six.
And overlap them on the sides. Why?
Cause I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make it. Ooh.
I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make it. Ooh. I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. I'ma teach you how to make lasagna. Ooh, yeah. Take half of the ricotta cheese. Spread it out over the dishes. Start that with mozzarella cheese. Then we slice it out with peas. 1.5 cups of sauce on my soda. Sprinkle quarter cup on my zone and that's it. 6 more noodles we break the process. Put the lines of sauce on my soda. Take that for the split it with that cube.
Thank you.
The Red Bull came for a unicorn, so she had to become something else. The magic chose the shape, not I. I am a bearer. I am a dwelling. I am a messenger.
You are an idiot. Do you hear me? You've lost her. You've trapped her in a human body. She'll go mad.
I can change her back. Don't worry about it. I can change her back.
Open up and breathe. One.
I'm a unicorn.
Come on with me. Five.
Magic
move. Five. Yes. Five. Five. Three. Four. Where are we? Five.
I wish you had left the red pool.
Roll it back. Back.
I wish you had left me alone.
Now double it. Five. Six. Seven. And again. Wait. One. Two.
Shake the crowd, you help me. remember, I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder.
Good health. Back. Take me higher. Point it. Two. Three.
higher, higher. That's, you got it. Point it. And we're gonna start from the beginning of the song. Sunshine, tricep and clap. Sunshine, tricep, clap. Tricep, clap. Tricep, clap. A little higher. A little higher. Now go back. I'm proud of you. Keep going. We're gonna raise the roof now.
Full of monkeys. And there extravaganza. And now, the man who can't wait to get his paws on your videos, Tom Bergeron!
Oh, Mr. Postman! Yeah! Oh, hi! Oh, time for some letters. Here's a very interesting letter for you. Dear Richard, I was at the mall the other day and I passed by one of those frozen yogurt stands. Well, I was hungry from all the walking around I was doing, so I decided to stop and get some. They asked me what size I wanted and I said a small cup. Then they asked me if I wanted non-fat yogurt and I said yes. Aren't you proud of me? And then they asked me what topping I wanted. Well, that's when I fell apart. They had some of those chocolate peanut butter candy bars all crunched up, and I just couldn't resist. So here's my question. Can I have some toppings on my yogurt? And if so, what can I have? Sincerely, Jill. Well, Jill, I'm glad you're eating non-fat yogurt. But before I answer your question, I have a question for you. For heaven's sakes, what the heck are you putting crunched up candy bar toppings on your yogurt in the first place? I thought you wanted to lose weight, not put any more on. Non-fat yogurt is a great snack to have, and I commend you for resisting all those other tempting goodies you find in the mall. But you have to remember, if you start piling up toppings on your yogurt, you're going to defeat the purpose of trying to lose weight. These toppings will add up calories faster than you can count them. You know, frozen yogurt became very popular about 4 or 5 years ago. It seemed like these yogurt places just popped up everywhere. When they first started out, you couldn't get non-fat yogurt. Well, the good thing now is that non-fat yogurt is easily available. But don't fall into the trap of adding all those toppings. If you can't eat just plain white yogurt, then choose a fruit topping, like strawberries or a fresh fruit combo. That will help you stay out of trouble. Just remember to count your fruit cart if you have a topping. And oh, by the way, limit your yogurt snack to 1/2 cup of non-fat yogurt and count 1 dairy cart. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Dear Richard, my friend told me about this non-fat cottage cheese that she just tried. She said it tasted really good. I want to try some of this too. But I don't know how many cards to count for this. Could you tell me? Sincerely, Sue. Well, Sue, you can count this 2 ways. Because it has no fat, you can have 1/2 cup of this non-fat cottage cheese instead of 1/4 cup for 1 dairy card. But if 1/4 cup is all you want, you may count it as a joker card. It's up to you. So go ahead and try it and let me know how you like it. We have time for one more, and here it is. Richard, is it okay to have sour cream? I have to confess, I just love party dip. But I'm sure there's lots of fat in sour cream. Can you help me out on this one? Sometimes I get a real craving for chips and dips. What shall I do? Thanks, Pat. All right.
All right, you caught me at a weak moment.
I know I told you before, somewhere in these tapes, how much I love chips and dips too. Well, you can't make dip without the sour cream. And yes, there is a lot of fat in sour cream, which is why it's on the fat card. But fortunately, we have an alternative. Now there is a non-fat sour cream on the market today. 2 tablespoons of this non-fat sour cream equals about 15 calories. So that means 1/4 cup of this sour cream will cost you about 30 calories or 1 joker card. The non-fat sour cream is certainly better than the regular kind. But don't think you can sit down and eat an entire 8-ounce container with a bag of chips. Try making a dip for fresh cut up vegetables instead. You'll still get the crunch like you would with the chips, but without the calories. Keep the letters coming. I'll keep answering them. Bye-bye. Oh, Mr. Punk.
I see now that the circumstances of one's birth are irrelevant. It is what you do with the gift of life that determines who you are.
Well, Bob, who? You too. Where are you going?
Where my heart can learn what yours knows so well. What transpired here, I will always remember. But perhaps for you, these events are best forgotten.
We'll be right back.
Y'all know what it is. Katy Perry. Juicy J. Let's rave.
And here you were. You were gonna come to me.
And here you are.
But you better choose carefully.
Cause I'm
capable of anything. Of anything. And everything.
Make me your Aphrodite. Make me your one and only.
Don't make me your enemy. Your enemy. Your enemy.
So you wanna play with magic? Boy, you should know what you're falling for. Baby, do you dare to do this? Cause I'm coming at you like a dark horse.
Paper, but her cousin is kind of a what's the word I'm looking for?
Pain in the butt.
That'll work.
That's him.
Dad, you never saw us. And if he asks where we are, we were never here and we're never coming back.
Got it. How annoying could one kid be? Hi, Steve. Listen, Steve, DJ and Julie were never here and they're never coming back.
Never? Well, that's okay, I'll wait. Steve, you have a spare accordion? We can jam.
My accordion is in the shop. How you doing? I'm Danny Tanner, DJ's dad. That's Jesse Gasopoulos, my brother-in-law.
You should have acted.
Joey's not here.
They are already here.
Jesse's best man.
Dragonborn.
That's the way to go. And it's a strut. And it's cool. And it's a strut. And it's cool like that too.
Feel the blood flowing a lot.
The Elder Scrolls told of their return.
Well, here's another fun way to
until
kill time.
The time
let's
after Oblivion opened.
I'll go first.
When the sons of Skyrim would spill their own blood.
Now, in your first letter, you told me that your mom and dad bought you Deal a Meal, and then you had not to go on it because you hurt your back. What happened?
Right. They got me the, you know, the Deal a Meal, and I was all excited to go on my diet, and I was, you know, really ready because nothing else really motivated me. And as I was thinking about the diet, I listened to the Project Meal tape, and they really made me feel good about myself. They really made me feel good, like I could do it and everything. And then I went and got my back really messed up.
And you were in bed for like 6 months.
Right, I couldn't move. And you know why my back was like that was because of my weight.
How much did you weigh at the highest?
I think it was 203 pounds.
203 pounds. And how much have you lost?
78 pounds.
Whoa! Can you actually believe this? I mean,
I don't believe it.
I'm looking at these pictures of you and you're in a bathing suit.
Yeah, you like that bathing suit?
It's gorgeous. You look like the cover of a magazine.
Thank you.
What does Dennis, your husband, think of all this?
Oh, he thinks it's great, but he said he's not letting me on the beach this summer.
When you were overweight, you told me that you never, ever got in a bathing suit.
No, I had to have a t-shirt on and shorts on, and I hated going to the beach. I hated it. Absolutely would not go.
And now?
And now. I can't wait to get there.
Why do you love yourself so much now, Kathy?
Because I did it. I'm so proud. I actually accomplished something in my life. And I can actually wear a pair of sweatpants and go to the store and look good.
Now, where is Dennis?
Where is Dennis?
Yeah.
He's working.
Is he?
Mm-hmm.
And I know that sometimes when you exercise,
Dennis goes in the other room and what?
When I do the sweat into the oldies,
uh-huh.
He's all, you know, he feels really happy for me, and he's like, I can't believe he's doing it, but he knows how much I love food. So sometimes I'll hear it out of the corner of my ear, I'll hear like crinkling walking by me,
uh-huh.
And I'll pause the tape for a minute, and I'll run in the bedroom,
and
he'll be hiding behind the bed.
You still have
watching
debris
TV
on the sand and in the water, but as you can see behind me, people
he must be as proud
beach,
of you as I am proud of you.
Here.
I mean, you know, people make millions of excuses, and it would have been very easy for you to say, well, I have a bad back, and I can't do this, and I can't exercise. But you didn't say that to yourself, did you?
And the highway.
At first, I kind of did. I put myself down all the time. I'm not worth it, you know, I'm no good. And I remembered about the after I had the operation on my back, I remembered about my boxing in the closet. I was watching my face again, and you know, Richard thinks I'm worth it, I think I'm worth it. And look at me, and I said, I'm going to do it. I said, when I do, I'm going to write him a letter, and he's going to get in touch with me. And you did.
I can't tell you how beautiful you look. I can't tell you how proud I am of you. And I certainly hope that you continue to exercise and you can continue to eat healthy. What is keeping you going, Kathy?
This body. Looking in the mirror every day and smiling instead of frowning.
I'm so glad that I could be a part of it. Would you please write and let me know how you're doing?
I will. You are the biggest part of it. I want to thank you so much for everything you're doing. And you've made my whole life now. I don't think I'll ever gain weight again. Just made my whole life.
Promise me one thing. When you're on the beach this summer with Dennis, you'll take another photo and send it to me.
You sure will. I'll be nice and tan for you.
You be sweet. Thanks for letting me call you.
Okay, I love you.
I love you too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
She turned herself in that she was strong enough to open that box. Where is your box? Where is that feeling? Where are those tapes? Look at these pictures. You could be in this picture for me.
Look at you, a general, huh?
Someone must have told him about my little maneuver at the Battle of Tenev.
Well, don't look at me, pal. I just said you were a fair pilot. I didn't know they were looking for somebody to lead this crazy attack.
I'm surprised they didn't ask you to do it.
Well, who says they didn't, but I ain't crazy. You're the respectable one, remember?
The Emperor's made a critical error, and the time for our attack has come. The data brought to us by the Bothan spies pinpoints the exact location of the Emperor's new battle station. We also know that the weapon systems of this Death Star are not yet operational. With the Imperial fleet spread throughout the galaxy in a vain effort to engage us, it is relatively unprotected. But most important of all, we've learned that the Emperor himself is personally overseeing the final stages of the construction of this Death Star. Many Bothans died to bring us this information. Admiral Ackbar, please.
You can see here the Death Star orbiting the forest moon of Endor. Although the weapon systems on this Death Star are not yet operational, the Death Star does have a strong defense mechanism. It is protected by an energy shield, which is generated from the nearby forest moon of Endor. The shield must be deactivated if any attack is to be attempted. Once the shield is down, our cruisers will create a perimeter while the fighters fly into the superstructure and attempt to knock out the main reactor. General Calrissian has volunteered to lead the fighter attack.
Good luck. You're gonna need it.
General Nadine.
We have stolen a small Imperial shuttle. Disguised as a cargo ship and using a secret Imperial code, a strike team will land on the moon and deactivate the shield generator.
Sounds dangerous.
I wonder who they found to pull that off.
General Solo, is your strike team assembled?
My team's ready. I don't have a command crew for the shuttle. That's gonna be rough, pal. I didn't want to speak for you. That's one.
General, count me in.
I'm with you, too.
What is it?
Ask me again sometime.
Luke.
Hi, Han. Chewie. Mm. Exciting is hardly the word I would choose.
Look, I want you to take her. I mean it. Take her. You need all the help you can get. She's the fastest ship in the fleet.
All right, old buddy. No, I know what she means. I'll take good care of her. She won't get a scratch. All right?
Right. I got your promise.
Enough is enough! I have had it with these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane! Everybody strap in! I'm about to open some fucking windows. Enough is enough! I have had it with these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane! Everybody strap in! I'm about to open some fucking windows. Enough is enough! I have had it with these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane! Everybody strap in! I'm about to open some fucking windows. Enough is enough! I have had it with these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane! Everybody strap in! I'm about to open some fucking windows.
Hey, you awake?
Yeah, I just got a funny feeling. Like I'm not gonna see her again.
Come on, Jim. Let's move.
Right. Chewie, let's see what this piece of junk can do. Ready, everybody?
All set. Here we go again.
All right, hang on.
Of the rebel fleet massing near Sullus.
It is of no concern.
Soon the rebellion will be crushed and Luke Skywalker will be one of us. Your work here is finished, my friend. Go out to the command ship and await my orders.
When I heard about the bubble, I was just amazed. I just never heard of anything like this.
If you drive a boat, nobody here. Bubble, nobody did before.
Like a hamster inside a wheel, the world-class athlete learned to walk on water more than 1,000 miles from Miami to Bermuda.
No one person is going to overcome the ocean. There was only going to be a bad outcome. This is by far the most bizarre case that I was involved with.
So there's no motors. He runs in that thing and powers it.
From here to Bermuda.
With the Bermuda Triangle and all these vessels disappearing over the years. They thought it was a suicide mission.
I really didn't know if he was going to come home alive or not. They were saying how it cost taxpayer money and the crazy Florida man. I mean, we can't help what people think.
You follow your dreams. Same name coming after you. You must follow your dreams.
I don't know. Fly casual.
Where is that shuttle going?
Shuttle to Darien. What is your cargo and destination?
Parts and technical proof. Fourth moon.
Do they have a code clearance?
It's an older code, sir, but it checks out. I was about to clear them.
Endangering the mission, I shouldn't have come.
Imagination. Come on, let's keep a little optimism.
Shall I hope?
No. Leave them to me. I will deal with them myself.
I should whisper. All right.
Now drop the right shoulder underneath your thigh and reach your right hand between your legs. Wrap your left arm around your body with your right hand. Grab onto your left wrist. Inhale, lift the chest away from the tailbone. Exhale, press the arm straight. Open up your chest towards the sky.
This is not human. I thought yoga was about Reaper and Ravi Shankar.
And now back on your buttocks. Press the left heel forward, and with both hands, lift the foot over your head.
Hi, Pete. I hate to disturb you, but I have a couple of openings for past life regression therapy.
I think at this point, I would volunteer lab testing. Give me up.
Now, it's not unusual for a person to question the reality of past lives. So let's begin by shaking off our uncertainty and doubt. Just shake off that cosmic debris.
My name is Greg FPS, the Zombies Extraordinaire, and welcome back to another video. This is not zombies, this is Modern Warfare. But today, guys, I have a introduction of possibly a new series, which is going to be titled Inside the Headset. I'm hoping I can sprinkle these videos.
This game is so fucking boring. I am beyond tired. What's that fucking game here? Fucking VO2 or something, holy shit. Yeah, you don't think this game is shit?
I mean, I think it's...
You like the fucking Battlefield? This is fucking Battlefield.
Battlefield is a good game. But if you ain't good at this game a lot, you ain't gonna like it, though.
No! No! That's this Call of Duty, this fucking camp. Bitch, you can hear people's footsteps from 30 fucking feet away. Didn't know he was there, he's crouched at camping in a fucking corner. He's crouched! In a fucking building! I'm about to cry, dude. This is fucking hard! I can go from BO4, the most fucking fast-paced fucking Call of Duty, to this. This shit's fucking...
Bro, relax, bro. The game's been out for 4 fucking days. They got shit to improve, but
it's been four
I like
minutes.
It
we
over.
Got 30 fucking kills. This is fucking insane.
I like it over some other previous Call of Duty, so I'm just happy to be back with Call of Duty. You need to give it a chance. How old are you?
Fucking 20.
Yeah, bro, you're too old to be that person, bro. You need to relax.
How old are you?
23. You gotta relax. Just came out and they're doing updates and starting fucking Black Ops 3. Black Ops 2 is the best Call of Duty.
I don't know about that.
Black Ops 3 is fucking trash, bro.
Holy fuck! You can't even spawn in this map!
Holy
thousand things waiting for you to walk in the fucking plane. They should have more cover in this fucking factor. Holy shit.
Yeah, I'm not playing it.
Guy? Oh, that's the courtyard. Long room camping at R8.
Oh, that's so shotgun.
Grenade! There's no way the grenade should have killed me from there. You know, Greg FPS is really the good team.
Less than a minute.
The one where I usually go? Yeah.
Right front, he's got the right shot right there. Oh, good.
Ah! I didn't know how far that bus came.
You still caught one in your mouth.
I didn't know how far the bus came! He has double the XP.
Is that a retractor?
That's not one for stuff.
No way.
Well, there goes our happy ending.
I mean, shotguns got stupid range.
Funk. Oh, junk.
Push it like a push.
Just on the night.